It's time we answer a question on your stock in a little segment we like to call Your Stock, Our Take. Buy, sell, or hold.
So Northland Power, currently trading right now at about $43. It's an almost $10 billion market cap company, and they are a renewable power producer. Northland owns 2.3 gigawatts net of generating capacity. Most of the company's power is offshore wind. They also have some onshore renewable assets as well. The company has executed a very aggressive growth strategy for years. This strategy has generally prioritized growth in the size of the company over accretive growth in per share earnings and cash flow. The Q4 results were released on February 22nd. Revenues in 2020 increased 24% to $2.06 billion, and adjusted EBITDA increased 19% to $1.17 billion. Adjusted free cash flow per share did lag this growth, increasing 6% to $2.09. The company has also provided guidance for 2021, and they expect adjusted free cash flow in the range of $1.80 to $2 per share. So what are our thoughts on Northland? Well, Northland has benefited from the trend toward renewable power and decarbonization, and we certainly expect that this trend is going to continue. The aggressive growth strategy has been focused on increasing the overall size of the company over growing the per share earnings and cash flow. We prefer a strategy that is more focused on growing the per share earnings and cash flow. But that said, to be fair to the company, cash flow per share has been growing over the years, just at a lower rate. In the last couple of years specifically, the growth in per share performance has really slowed. Guidance for 2021 puts cash flow about where it was in 2018, in spite of adjusted EBITDA increasing almost 30%. So what investors need to consider is that when the company is targeting doubling their adjusted EBITDA over the next 5 to 10 years, you can't just assume that the growth in per share earnings and cash flow is going to mirror that adjusted EBITDA growth. It's more than likely, it's certainly going to fall well short of that, and more than likely substantially short of that. But overall, we do think that this is a solid business. It's in an attractive theme. It has stable cash flow. I'd like to see more of a focus on per share growth. It's not particularly cheap at about 22 times expected 2021 free cash flow, especially considering that cash flow is expected to decline in 2021. In the near term, the company looks fairly valued to me. But over the longer term, say a 5 to 10 year time horizon, the company could continue to do well, particularly if it produces better per share accretive growth from its development portfolio and acquisition.